Piecewise Functions, a la Shmoop. John Lemon and Yoko Fro-yo run an unusually successful and long-standing lemonade and yogurt stand in a highly populated metropolitan area. It's the end of a long day and time to chart the daily earnings. From 6 a.m. to noon, John runs the stand. In order to attract people to the stand, he plays acoustic guitar and sings soothing classic rock songs at no extra charge. Yesterday, all my yogurt seemed so far away. He makes about $8 an hour. Not bad for a lemonade and yogurt stand guy. John's earnings can be represented by the equation f of x equals 8x, where $8 an hour times x, the number of hours worked since 6 a.m., will give us the monetary total. At noon, John leaves to work on his music, and Yoko takes over the stand until 6 p.m. To attract people to the stand, she does various performance art pieces at no extra charge, including a juggling hippo. Unfortunately, she doesn't have as many fans as John. She makes about $5 an hour. Poor Yoko.
No one understands my art.
Yoko's earnings can be represented by the equation g of m equals 5m, where m equals the number of hours since 12 p.m. How do we combine these two equations in one earnings chart? The answer lies in a piecewise function. A piecewise function is a function that acts differently on different pieces or parts of the function. We can create a comprehensive piecewise function that takes into account both John and Yoko's total earnings over the course of the day. And here's what the function looks like. F of x equals 8x when x is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 6, since John works from 6 a.m. till noon. And 8 times 6, that's John's $48 from his shift, plus 5 times x minus 6, when x is greater than 6 and less than or equal to 12, since the stand closes at 6 p.m., 12 hours after 6 a.m. X is equal to the number of hours worked since 6 a.m., which is why the second half of the function, which represents Yoko's earnings, contains x minus 6. Her shift doesn't start until noon, so the 6 hours before the switch don't apply. And of course, f of x is the total earnings of the day. And now everything can be shown on one chart. All we do is graph the function. Both pieces are line segments, so 2 points per piece are sufficient to graph the function. For the first line segment, for when x is greater than or equal to 0, or less than or equal to 6, we can plug in x as 0 to get 0, 0 as one endpoint. To get the other endpoint, we can plug x as 6 to get 6, 48. For the second line segment, for when x is greater than 6 and less than or equal to 12, we can plug in 6 as x. 8 times 6 is 48, plus 5 times 0, so you have 48 plus 0, or 48. So our first endpoint is 6, 48. To get the endpoint of the last piece, we can plug in 12 into the 8 times 6 plus 5 times x minus 6. To get 48 plus 5 times 6, 5 times 6 is 30, so 48 plus 30 in California equals 78. So our endpoint for the second line segment is 1278. Perfect, we can graph it now. Piecewise functions are just big functions made out of smaller pieces of other functions. John loves them so much, he even has a song about them. Give Piecewise a chance. Give Piecewise a chance. Yesterday.